the backbone of one of the biggest European comic publishers, the Belgian publisher Dupuis, is its weekly comic magazine named after its title character, Spirou. And this year, what you can see is one of these nice, very nice collected editions that have come out in the last couple of years over here. Now we're with Tom et Jerry. They called themselves so because of the similar sound to Tom and Jerry. They put up the notch, the speed in some of their stories quite a bit, and the amount of detail and fun that is going on in each of these time travel crazy adventures for old and young. Really, I like these Tom et Jerry stories almost as much, or even as much, as I did like the classic Franquin stories. So, and this is my rank 30 in my third video with my favorite comics, collected editions, graphic novels, and so on from the wicked year 2021. Rank 30. On 29, we have this thing here, Echo der Städte, Echo of the Cities. What is it actually? Beautiful, of course, and a facsimile reprint of newspaper articles. But from newspapers that were published in the obscure cities. So we have reports, interviews, other articles about events, happenings, and famous and important characters of this imaginative and imaginatory parallel universe of Skuyton and Peters. So this is the wet dream of a Skuyton fanatic, of course, as you can think, and I'm pretty very much a Skuyton fan, of course. The only reason why this ranks not at my top one in this list here, because yeah, I would do so totally, is that in the meantime I hunted down this beauty here. This is the original thing. Different font, different size, of course, and generally speaking, just the bit better package here, and it really gives you this newspaper feel. So after checking out this year, I thought, hey, I have to put this a bit down on my top 50 list, but still, if this thing here is pretty hard to get, I looked for it quite a while for a decent price. This year is a new publication, easily to get in German or French. This is rank 28 and a book that I recently spoke about in my video about the works of Daniel Gigel. Nobody but you, Niemand außer dir, and this is a book that needs very few words to create a dense atmosphere of melancholy and dread and sorrow. It's the letter of a dead soldier to his wife that he has to leave in this world. I'm pretty inconsistent sometimes in my arguments. I know sometimes I like, don't like art that leans heavily on photo references, and sometimes, like it is the case with Daniel Gigel, I really cherish the poetic atmosphere and what he does with his painterly abstractions over photographic templates. And yeah, this is a very moody, atmospheric book, and not the last one in my top 50 book here by Daniel Gigel. After my video, I hunted down more books by Gigel and ordered this book here, Sex et Violence. And this is an interesting title, of course, but a pretty stupid title when you see what comic it contains. It's exactly the comic that I've shown you right there. And for this story, this title here really, I don't know. No harm done. I will resell this book on eBay, of course, and yeah, not because it's a bad comic, of course, but I don't need the same comic twice. On rank 27, we have. Oh, yeah, it's a manga. You put the book the other way around. The last volume of Monster, representing the whole series, of course, and which was a fascinating ride. I didn't have bought the premise, especially for the ending and the big finale of the series. Lacked a lot in believability, but how Naoki Urasawa creates his story out of the slew of different characters is very, impressing. On 26, we have another comic that I've spoken about in an earlier video. I mean, I talked about Jijel and I talked about Monster. And I talked, of course, about this book here, a comics memoir by Glenn Head. If it is a masterpiece, like Robert Crumb says on the cover here, you have to decide for yourself. But you won't be able to put this book down until it's finished, and it will really, hold you, take a hold on you, because this is not a light story, even though it is cartooned in this very fun way, or the Glenn Head way. But it's about his experiences on a private school, and especially the schoolmaster here, who molested his students, and one of them, Glenn Head. And these events from 1 year in this private school haunted his life until now. So he still has to deal with the trauma and the memories from way back then, and we can really see it. And he is brutally honest with himself. He doesn't show himself just as a poor victim or whatever, but as a flawed person who doesn't know. Are these flaws because of the school or whatever? Now, for a change of tone, we have a much more light-hearted book, on the first glance at least. On 25, we have this baby here, In the Head of Sherlock Holmes. This came out as an original in French. I don't think that there is an English version out yet, but I really hope so. This is a two-in-one edition, album-sized format. And as you can see, the cover takes the title In the Head of Sherlock Holmes literally, because when you open the book here, you're right there in the head and in the mind of Sherlock Holmes. He is on a bookshelf that is titled with crimes and so on. Here we have our Sherlock Holmes in a drug-abused heavy dream, almost a coma. Then he wakes up and has a new case on his hand, and this is the case of the mysterious ticket. And in this comic, we have not only these very imaginative layout arrangements, and we have a red thread going through the whole story, connecting all the clues that our Sherlock guy picks up. But we have here again a view into his head, so that we can see what's going on there, how he puts these clues together to solve the crime. And sometimes you can put pages together here, like so. And on some pages, you can look through the page, and you see something new shining through the page. And you got maps, you got other arrangements, and the crime itself actually is very interesting. And then it isn't this harmless Sherlock Holmes anymore story anymore, but a pretty harsh, sarcastic critique on the society back then and colonialism and so on. But I don't want to spoil it for you. Just look at this double page here, and yeah, for those of you who can read French or German, this is highly, highly recommended. For the rest of you, yeah, just pest your local comic publisher to publish this book here, because this is really, yeah, one of these books that can't be replaced so easily by other more generic stuff. Really, really liked it. As you can see, the higher we go up the ranks in my list, the more interchangeable actually the books are. I could put them in different orders and would be okay with it. But nevertheless, I felt a bit that for some reasons, 24 Providence was maybe even more, a bit more recommended than Sherlock Holmes. Boy, was I wrong. The first reading experience with the English tome by Avatar Press, yeah, didn't succeed it with me because it was way too much reading. I mean, these computer form mimicking handwriting is still not one of my faves, but when I had to read this in English, it was even more of a chore. So, still not totally into all of the storytelling tricks of Alan Moore here, but overall, there's this pastiche of different Lovecraft themes to one scenario of Lovecraft lore is nothing less but fascinating and rewarding the next read-through big time, I guess. So this was in Germany a two-volume publication here, collecting the Avatar stories in two volumes, and my rank 24. On 23, we have this beautiful book here, Bram Stoker's Dracula, this time adapted by one Georges Bess, who gave us beautiful books, for an example, The White Llama, together with Alessandro Jodorowsky. And I mean, it's Dracula, you know what you get with the story and with the characters, but boy, the more so you can enjoy the art here by Georges Bess, which is really breathtaking in its black and white glory. Beautiful stuff. And yeah, you can go on each page here and look for amazing stuff. Look like this demon here, or vampire, of course, crawls down the wall and into the world. I have seen a lot of renditions of Dracula, but this here has to be one of my absolute favorites in regard of that. Beautiful. And a beautiful tome by Splitter. They really became one of my favorites in terms of publisher of European comics. And now to one of the most underrated series and cartoonists, in my humble opinion, Jérôme K. Jérôme Bloch by Alain Daudier. This is the German collected edition, volume 9, containing the albums 25 to 27. The series is still ongoing, but we are pretty much in up to the last published album right now, right there. IDW, with their Eurocomics line, tried to publish this in English. I don't know how well it sold, but it was a bit unfortunate that they started with the very first albums, who are not as good as, for example, the stories in this book. At a certain point, each and every Jérôme K. Jérôme Bloch or Jackie Kotwitz, as the German title goes, is impeccable. Is just fantastic, paced, crime stuff with wonderful dialogues, very thoughtful in its presentation. For an instance, in the first album, our Jérôme has to deal with this young African woman here called Aina, and she lives in Paris, or she was brought to Paris under conditions and has to live there under conditions that you only can describe as modern slavery. And really feels real, and it is really a story that doesn't leave you cold, as all these stories, they don't necessarily have a dead body in it, the least of them. The stories by of Jérôme K. Jérôme Bloch are more about bribery and thievery and all the smaller evil stuff that humans can do to each other. And I really love the dynamics between Jérôme, who is nothing but a hard-boiled detective. He's a very emotional, sensitive young man, and his girlfriend Babette. Now we arrived at the last book for today's video, and that is actually a series. Search and Destroy by Atsushi Kaneko concluded after this third volume here, about cyborg girl and her friend there. She tries to hunt down her lost body parts from those who have robbed it from her. And there are some surprises and some twists, but to be honest with you, the real star here in this manga is the astonishing art that looks really like a mixture, like I said in my video, of Charles Burns and Paul Pope to me. And not a bad version of Charles Burns and Paul Pope, really. It's wonderful, wonderful stuff, and highly, highly recommended, like actually each and every book of that I've showed you today and that I will show you in the next two videos. So stay tuned. One last thing though, because Atsushi Kaneko struck me as such an interesting mangaka, that I had to hunt down this series here, Wet Moon, by the same creator. And haven't read it yet, but the art looks amazing as well. I mean, wonderful and absolutely not understandable that this series seemingly wasn't put out in English as of now. I mean, we can hope. So, but that's all for now. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.